Hi everyone, thank you so much for joining me today. It's a special day for me and a special video because I'm celebrating my birthday. Yeah! It's my 42nd birthday. No jokes. No jokes about age. Only joking. Joke away, it's all good fun. So I've made a creation that's happy and vibrant and it uses lots of different colours of the rainbow or the chakra. And it's a real celebration piece, and I really hope that you enjoy watching me create this. It's a piece that is part of my Colour of Emotion series. So as the weeks and the months go on, you'll see me releasing all different creations with different colours, focusing on the emotions element and what emotions are linked to different colours. So I hope you enjoy it. This one is all about celebration, having fun, and it's very, very vibrant. So I think it's a good fit for a special day like my birthday. So thank you so much for joining me today. I hope you celebrate along with me. Drop me some comments below. Let me know what you think, and let's see what we can create. Okay, so I'm using a 12 by 12 inch canvas and I'm going to be using all the rainbow colours, so red, orange, yellow, green, blue and violet. And I'm also going to add a little bit of gold because I love gold. So I'm going to lay the base down and I'm using a titanium white by System 3 acrylic. And I'm just going to make sure that I've got a good consistency and a good layering on the base of the canvas. I'm going to just, there's some air bubbles, but I'll get those in a minute. I'm just going to spread some of that out. And then, as you can see, I'm just covering most of the base, but I'm not going to stretch it all across the canvas because when I layer the colours and then I swipe through, I will stretch more of that out just to get that design. Okay, so I'm just going to get rid of those air bubbles. And I've got air bubbles because I've just mixed my paints. So if I'd mixed them the day before and let them settle, there'd be less air bubbles. But I've only just done it, so I wanted to get those air bubbles out. So I'm going to start layering my paints. Definitely going to go with the red first. And I'm going to just put just a little bit on first and then add the next colour slightly on top, but just keeping the same direction as I go through. And I've had the inspiration from Molly, from Molly's Artistry. You've probably seen her Bright Line series. So if not, go and check it out. It's fantastic. But I'm using the basis and the concept of that idea to create my celebration piece for my birthday. So just get that bubble. So just now with the blue. And then the violet. Okay, so I don't think I'm going to add any more. I'm just going to put some gold all the way through. Just a nice little addition. Yeah, I'm definitely not going to put any more of the colour down on the base. This is my Australian Floetrol mixed with some of the white titanium. And I'm going to use that as my magic ingredient to get those cells and lacing as I swipe. So I've got my palette knife, and the idea is just to coat the palette knife with the Australian Floetrol with the white and swipe it all the way across. So I'm only going to use a little bit. I'm going to use this sparingly because obviously being based in the UK, it's really difficult to get Australian Floetrol. So I don't want to waste an ounce. So I've got enough on there, and then I am going to take my palette knife and I'm going to put a good covering on my palette knife, and then I'm going to literally just swipe across. OK, Okay, so just a good covering. Ooh, here we go. Deep breath. And then just all the way down, just lightly all the way over the top, swiping through, just dragging those colours on top of each other. And then I'll just go over the edge there, because that's going to go off the, that's going to go off the edge anyway. So, good. Oh, I can already see some of the cells forming. So that's good. I think I've managed to create what I'm going to be able to create and have a good consistency. That's always the key, isn't it? I'm just going to use my torch just to get rid of any air bubbles and also to see what cells I can bring through. I can see some real good formations all the way through, and I think I've managed to keep all those colours. So I was really worried that I was going to swipe and almost swipe across and lose some of those colours. So what I'm going to do now is I'm just going to carefully and slowly, I'm just mesmerised by some of the cells that are popping up. So yeah, I'm just going to carefully and slowly just get the design, think about the composition, and I'm going to tilt and stretch this design across the canvas. I'm thinking that I still want some negative space. I think I want some negative space on two of the corners. And then obviously I'd like to stretch the colours over the other two corners. So I always try and have in my mind when I'm doing a creation, I always think about the actual design that I want to create on the canvas. And if I want any negative space, if I do want negative space, then it's almost you kind of have to work out where you're putting your paint in the first place, if that makes sense. Because if you want some negative space, which I do on this design, I want to make sure that as I'm stretching it out, that I don't almost like overstretch and not keep enough negative space to help with that composition and that balance. Because I think, you know, that's something really important that I've got in my mind when I'm doing these types of pieces, especially when they're on smaller canvases as well. So yeah, I'm just stretching it across, as you can see. I love some of these colours, and I'm really lucky I've kept my yellow. My yellow I was more worried about, but I can still see some of the yellow on the in the middle, and just along the edge, it's quite golden actually. So maybe that's some of the gold that's shining through as well. So I'm just going to turn it round. And yeah, I'm really liking this so far. I'm really, really happy with it. The red, wait until I take you in for a closer look. The red is just so vibrant, and the red is actually really stunning when it's mixed with that orange. Okay. So I'm just going to stretch the other corner over the edge. Again, I don't want to lose too much of the violet, so I'm just slowly doing it, and I'm turning it as I do it. Just going to put a little bit more paint there, just to allow it to flow a bit better. And then once it's over that corner, I will then stretch it back. And I will almost kind of step back and take a look at that composition and the actual design. I'm going to tidy up my sides. If I haven't got the full side coverage, I'm not too worried, because I can do that. Look at this. Wow, I've managed to keep all of those colours. And I'm hoping that as it dries, it's going to be just as vibrant. Guys, this is a real, yeah, I'm really, really happy with this. This is a real celebration piece for me. It's a really happy piece. You know, it's my birthday. So, yeah, I'm so pleased I've done this design for this occasion. Just going to tip it up slightly, because I want to drag some of that paint back. Sorry, I've gone off camera, so you didn't see that. But what I'm doing is I'm just making sure that there aren't huge puddles of paint in certain areas, because I've said this in previous videos. When this piece is drying, I want the layer on the canvas to be pretty consistent and kind of flow all the way across, because if there's a puddle of paint and it dries at different rates, that's where my cracking is going to start, and I really don't want that for this piece because I love it already. Just being a bit biased there because I've done it myself, but yeah, I love it because it's my celebration piece. Okay, so I'm gonna take you in for a little look. Look at that, the red, how that red and orange have mixed together. And obviously the Australian Floetrol is the key here. See that yellow, just the yellow down the edge, and then we go into the green and the blue. Probably know by now, you know, I'm a big fan of green. Blues I absolutely love as well. I very rarely work with red, orange and yellow. But hey, for a celebration piece, I can't not have these colours all together. And I'm really happy with that composition. Remember what I said about the negative space as well. So yeah, I'm liking that look. And I'm hoping that it's going to dry really well as well. So I will take you in for that close up. Okay, so what I would say is, and I've made this mistake numerous times, make sure when you're leaving your canvas to dry, it's level. If it's not level at this stage, it will slip off the edge and you're going to ruin your design that you see here now. So that's my top tip. Okay, here we go. This is the dried version. Guys, I'm so happy with how this turned out and how it dried. I'm over the moon. It's a good birthday. It's a good celebration piece for me. It's a great addition to my Colour of Emotion series. This piece is part of that overall series that I said I will be creating and showcasing throughout the year. So I love this addition and I really, really hope you like it too. And I'm celebrating because this is my 42nd year on Earth. I'm going to make it a good one. I've got loads of plans, loads of creative projects in the pipeline that I can't wait to share with you all. And I hope that you'll be celebrating with me all the way throughout the year. I just want to say thank you so much for all of your support, for following me, for watching my videos and for taking time to comment and provide me with feedback. And it's always really encouraging feedback. So I just love reading all your comments and I do try and respond to absolutely everybody. So that is my commitment to you. So yeah, so thank you so much. I'm going to leave you with a few more close-ups of this piece. But in the meantime, I want to say have a great day and have a great week ahead. And I hope you'll celebrate with me, not just today, but throughout the year as you see me evolve and develop my creative journey. Thanks so much.